Welcome to the FolksLearn. Today we will learn how to create a login form with MySQL. Now we will set tab order for all controls. The tab order is the order in which the tab key moves the input focus from one control to the next within a dialog box. Usually the tab order proceeds from left to right and from top to bottom in a dialog box. Each control has a tab stop property that determines whether a control receives input focus. MySQL, the most popular open-source SQL database management system, is developed, distributed, and supported by Oracle Corporation. MySQL is a database management system. A database is a structured collection of data. It may be anything from a simple shopping list to a picture gallery or the vast amounts of information in a corporate network. To add, access, and process data stored in a computer database, you need a database management system such as MySQL Server. Since computers are very good at handling large amounts of data, database management systems play a central role in computing, as standalone utilities, or as parts of other applications. The MySQL database server is very fast, reliable, scalable, and easy to use. If that is what you are looking for, you should give it a try. MySQL Server can run comfortably on a desktop or laptop, alongside your other applications, web servers, and so on, requiring little or no attention. If you dedicate an entire machine to MySQL, You can adjust the settings to take advantage of all the memory, CPU power, and I/O capacity available. MySQL can also scale up to clusters of machines, networked together. Now we will insert two rows into users table. You should install MySQL for Visual Studio before adding a data source. It is a good practice to store the connection string for your application in a config file rather than as a hard-coded string in your code. Connection strings can be stored as key-value pairs in the connection string section of the configuration element of an application configuration file. Table adapters provide communication between your application and a database. More specifically, a table adapter connects to a database, executes queries or stored procedures, and either returns a new data table populated with the returned data or fills an existing data table with the returned data. Table adapters are also used to send updated data from your application back to the database. Table adapters are created with a dataset designer inside of strongly typed datasets. You can create table adapters during creation of a new dataset with the Data Source Configuration Wizard. You can also create table adapters in existing datasets with the Table Adapter Configuration Wizard or by dragging database objects from Server Explorer onto the dataset designer. While table adapters are designed with the dataset designer, the table adapter classes generated are not generated as nested classes of the dataset. They are located in a separate namespace specific to each dataset. To access a particular table adapter programmatically, you must declare a new instance of the table adapter. Thank you for watching this video.